Hi, good morning everyone. This is Indermeet Singh Bakshi and I'm a bachelor student and I'm doing BTech in biotechnology from Hindustan College of Science and Technology, Farre, Mathura. And this college is affiliated to Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Technical University, which is located at Lucknow. So I gave GATE biotechnology as well as life science this year and I got an AIR 1 in GATE biotechnology exam and an AIR 19 in GATE Excel exam. Talking about my family background, I belong to a middle class family and my dad is a businessman and my mother is a housewife. The feeling after GATE AIR 1 is unexpressible. I don't have enough words to express this feeling. It has always been a dream of not only me but every aspirant to get this rank in a national level exam. So to be honest, after I gave the exam, I knew that I'm going to score well because I gave my 100% in the preparation, and after the exam also, when I checked the answer key, I was getting around 74 marks. So overall, it was a very nice experience and I knew deep down that I can score a good rank. And going by the previous year trends, I knew that I can get AIR 1. So it is a very good feeling, and the best part of this was when the director of IIT Bombay called me before the result was announced to congratulate me about this exam, about the result. Talking about the preparation, I started my preparation around a couple of years back. At the start, it was not that particularly focused towards the GATE exam, but I used to read the reference books such as Leninger for biochemistry and Russell for genetics. So I loved those books, and when 2020 approached and the lockdown was called upon, then I started my preparation and focusing on GATE only. So during that moment, and talking about the hours of study, I gave around 5 to 6 hours daily to the study before the lockdown, and during the lockdown period, I used to study for around 8 to 10 hours per day. And talking about the last part of my preparation, like around a couple of months before the preparation, before the exam, I gave around 12 to 13 hours daily for the study. And during the last week, I gave around 15 to 16 hours and even 18 hours some day to the study. So it was a tough thing to do for me as a student because studying, no one likes studying that much. So, but I got used to it with times. E-Learnum came to my life in around July of 2019, and when I was looking for some coaching or some guidance for my preparation because I was going very wayward in my preparation. So E-Learnum came in my life and I talked to a senior who scored All India rank 10th from my college itself, and he used to study from Viren sir. So talking about Viren sir, he's an excellent teacher. I saw his lectures which were freely available on his YouTube channel. It was named Smart Learning Academy back then and now it is E-Learnum. So talking about E-Learnum, it is a very nice platform. I would suggest every student to look at the videos uploaded on YouTube, and even if you're not comfortable doing self-study, because I love doing self-study, so I did not opt for the coaching itself, but again then the videos really helped. So you can opt for coaching as well. I have seen his lectures. He's an amazing teacher and I would definitely like to thank him for his role in my preparation. And the major part of E-Learnum that I like the most is undoubtedly the group that the E-Learnum has. So the CSI on the group itself, there are around 3000 members and they post questions every day. So I tried to solve each and every questions and I responded to each and every question, and I also posted my queries on that page. So there were on that group. So there were many students who were pretty much better than me as well as which are below than me. I know, but still the people who are better than me, you can learn many things from them. So they solved my queries and as a result, my concepts got clearer with time and the result is in front of me now. So the group really helped and it is one of the best aspect of E-Learnum, because in other groups are not such active. I also joined groups of other coachings as well, but to be honest, this group of E-Learnum was the best among all. So for all the aspirants, I would like to suggest them this E-Learnum group. Now coming to the preparation point, there were a lot of distractions, to be honest. The major one being the college exams. So as most of the aspirants are the students of a final year BTech or the third year BTech, so the major issue is the attendance. The college attendance is very much necessary, but it is very difficult to study while attending classes. So the benefit that I got from being a private college is that the teachers knew me from the starting, as I was the university topper in the first, second and the third year. So they just tried to enhance my attendance themselves, even if I am not present physically in the class. So this was a plus point on my part. But again, you can bunk the lectures, as we all do. So it is not hidden from anyone that we can bunk the lectures and we can go to the library and study. So what I used to do is that I went to the library in the lunch of every day and I studied there. I read the reference books like the Duran for bioprocess, the Leninger for biochemistry, Russell for the genetics and various other books. And I utilized my even the lunch period and during the travel time. My home is about an hour drive from my college. So during that time, I utilize it for studying. So on the way to the college and back from the college to the home, I used to study in the bus itself. So it is the every bit of time that you can utilize in the lab. Also, when you are not doing anything, we can utilize the time. So in the lab, when during the practicals only, when we were free, then I, instead of talking with my friends, I used to study during that time. So now talking about the time management, and which is a very crucial aspect of every aspirant, and not even every aspirant, of every student itself. So during the lockdown, I have plethora of time, and it was because of that I have achieved this feat. So during the lockdowns, I used to it depends on person to person. If you are a night owl, you should study at night, and if you love waking up early and studying, then you can study in the early morning. I personally am a night owl, so what I used to do was that I stayed awake all the night long, and I used to sleep at 8 a.m. in the morning. So when I used to sleep, the best time of any study is the time when you are most active. So, and obviously the best time is when you wake up. So I used to wake up around 12 or at least 2 or 3 p.m. in the afternoon. So at 3 p.m. I used to study, and I used to study the most difficult aspect, which I found the most difficult one. I used to study when I wake up. So when I am done with that, then I used to revise the other aspects which I studied on the previous days, and after that I tried to solve the questions. As I got to know from all my seniors who have cleared this exam in the past, they used to solve each and every questions. I personally solved each and every previous year question around 3 times. It is not necessary that you belong to that you are giving the biotechnology exam, but you also need to solve the Excel questions also, because the major part of the Excel is same as that of the biotechnology. So solving the questions is very necessary. And now, sources of motivation. Everyone can have different sources of motivation, but what I believe personally is the biggest source of motivation is your parents. I have seen my father toil around at the shop. He's a businessman, so he goes to the shop at 7 in the morning and comes back in the 9 in the evening. So I have seen him go to the shop daily without skipping any day. So that is the biggest point of motivation. You can see your parents do hard work for you, even if they don't want to. When we feel like that we don't want to study, or we have done with it, now we can't do anymore, we can't tolerate this much study time. So the only thing that comes to my mind during that moment of time is that our parents, that they are also working every day even if they are not wanting to. So other sources of motivation can be, you can get motivation from someone that is better than you. There were many people on the group on the e-learning group that used to answer my questions, and I used to think that they would crack the gate exam with much better rank than me. So that was definitely a motivation. Whenever you prepare for some exam and you have aspirants with you, there comes a point of jealousy at a point, but it is fine until unless it is in a healthy manner. That particular aspect that someone is better than you, that can definitely motivate you to practice more and more, and till a point when you are better than him. There is always someone who is better than you always, and you can get motivation from him. Apart from that, Viren sir's shairies, as you all have heard, are definitely a point of motivation. I listened to his shairi on the last date before the exam as well, and I remembered it on the day of the exam. There were around 10 seconds left in the exam, and I still thought that I can give up, but then that shairi came to my brain, and then I tried to solve one question and I got the answer which came out to be right. So that definitely helped in solving one question and at least getting couple of marks. So thanks to Viren sir for that. Now talking about the future, now since the results are out and I have got a good rank, so I am looking at some IITs, because IISc is also an option, but they are having an integrated PhD and I am not good at lab work as of now. So I want to build my concepts and as well as also gain some experience in some labs, and my main aim is to settle abroad and do some research work. I am not focused towards the job aspect, so what I am trying to do is that I am looking for the IITs which have collabs with the foreign universities. So the ones that I prefer are Bombay, Kanpur, the biomedical stream in Bombay, the biological science and bioengineering department of Kanpur, and Guwahati. So these three would be my preferences, and in this particular order as well. Now study sources. Now the study sources can vary, but during the initial 1 year of my preparation, I used to read only the reference books. So as we all know, we have heard about the Pathfinder publication. It is a good book, no doubt in it, but still I think that it is very concise and brief. So one must go through the reference books in order to build the concepts, and once your concepts are clear, you can build upon it by reading the Pathfinder book at last. So during my first year of preparation, I used to read the reference books. The reference books, as we all know, the biochemistry Leninger or even Harper, and for the genetics Russell or Snustad, and for genetic engineering I used to read Primrose or T.A. Brown as well. And apart from it, bioprocess, it is much necessary to read Doran, Schuler and Whittaker as well. So these were the reference books. For immunology, it was Cube. For microbiology, it was Prescott, and from various other sources. One more thing that I would like to add is the NEPTEL lectures, which is the NPTEL lectures. I used to do the NEPTEL courses, and I did around 6 to 7 courses, and that definitely would help you to build your concepts. So I would encourage every upcoming aspirant to join the NEPTEL courses and study from the IIT lecturers which give their lectures, and that are really helpful. Now the journey from class 12th to AIR 1 in GATE. I did my 12th in 2016, and I had maths as well as bio in my 12th class. So I took a coaching for the NEET exam, and in that year they had both AIPMT and NEET, and to be honest, I did not study and failed in it miserably. So I got around 30,000 rank, and I didn't got any government seat, and it was around November when the counseling ended, and I did not get any seat in that counseling, not even the private colleges. So my father was saying that let's join a private college, but still I insisted him to not to do so, and since it was November, I joined an engineering college in computer science branch. So as the first year went, I just had 18% attendance, and then I decided it's better to leave the stream because I don't like it. So then I came back from that college and I joined a new college in my hometown. So I took up the biotech stream in this college, and from there onwards I got interest in this stream. I read the books, and on reading the books I thought that this is something that I love and this is my passion. I just thought that biotechnology is my passion and I should pursue it on a long term. I should build my career in it. So then I started my preparation for GATE, and the result is right in front of us. So now talking about the inspiration, there are various inspirational sources. As I already told, the parents being the first and the best inspirational source that one can have. The second one being the seniors who have already cleared these exams. Viren sir, he told us that he got AIR 6, and I saw his interview and was really inspired by him, and I thought that he was also from my university, so that was a plus point, and I thought that I have to be at least like him. I can never never become better than him, but at least I can be up to that point that I get a good rank in the university as well as the GATE. So now talking about positivity, to be honest, I'm a very pessimist person. So ऐसा सबको लगता है कि हाँ भाई, ये जो पूरी दुनिया है, ये पूरी मिलके हमारे खिलाफ कुछ साजिश कर रही है ना. तो अब ऐसा लगता था कि हाँ, ये सब चीज़ें जो हो रही हैं गलत हो रही हैं, मतलब कि पढ़ाई नहीं हो रही, सब लोग ज़्यादा पढ़ रहे हैं, हर इंसान हमसे ज़्यादा अच्छा है. तो हमें ऐसा ज़रूरी होता है, सबको लगता है ऐसा प्रिपरेशन के टाइम पे, कि हाँ यार, एवरी पर्सन दैट इज आंसरिंग योर क्वेश्चंस इन द ग्रुप इज बेटर देन यू. लेकिन टू बी ऑनेस्ट, ऐसा नहीं है. हर इंसान में कुछ ना कुछ वीकनेसेस होती हैं. सो ऑन द एंड डे, व्हाट मैटर्स मोस्ट इज हाउ मच यू आर पॉजिटिव, हाउ मच यू कीप यू मोटिवेटेड, व्हाट इज योर परसिवरेंस, हाउ मच इंस्पायर्ड यू आर towards your goal, and how much focused you are. So consistency is the key. So we have to study every day, and what I did is that I tried not to skip any day. Even if I study, even if I'm going out with my friends or doing anything, I used to study for a couple of hours at least every day. And other thing is that you can ignore your friends, you can keep them aside for at least a couple of years or so. If you are not having a couple of years, then during the major part of your preparation you will have your friends who will will go to the party, but you can ignore them. You can ignore your relatives for a time period. Everyone will come back when you will get a good rank. So हमें उन चीज़ों को साइड रखते हुए, मतलब वी मस्ट नो वेन टू से नो. सो कुछ करने से बेटर ये चीज़ है कि जो हमें नहीं करना वो चीज़ पता होना ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है. तो हम अपने रिलेटिव्स को, फ्रेंड्स को, सबको मना कर सकते हैं कि हम भाई ये चीज़ में नहीं इन्वॉल्व होंगे. वी हैव टू स्टडी, एज सिंपल एज दैट. सो दिस वॉज माई की टू सक्सेस. एक डाउट जो हर स्टूडेंट के माइंड में आता है कि सर प्रैक्टिस ज़्यादा करी जाए या फिर थ्योरी ज़्यादा याद करी जाए. सो अगर हम किसी और स्ट्रीम में होते जहाँ पे न्यूमेरिकल्स ज़्यादा आते हैं, तो ऑब्वियसली थ्योरी के साथ साथ प्रैक्टिस जो है वो बहुत ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है. लेकिन अपनी स्ट्रीम में भी प्रैक्टिस की उतनी ही इंपॉर्टेंस है. हम ऐसा सोच के लैक कर देते हैं कि नहीं यार प्रैक्टिस कर लेंगे, पहले थ्योरी पढ़ लेते, थ्योरी बहुत ज़्यादा. बट वन एस्पेक्ट दैट वी हैव टू फोकस इज दैट एवरी टॉपिक दैट वी रीड एवरी डे वी मस्ट सॉल्व द प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस ऑफ दैट टॉपिक ऑन दैट डे इटसेल्फ. अगर हमने एक दिन का पढ़ा हुआ टॉपिक अगले दिन के लिए छोड़ दिया, तो वो क्वेश्चंस उसके हमेशा के लिए छूट जाएंगे. वो टॉपिक हमारा धीरे धीरे फेड अवे हो जाएगा दिमाग से, क्योंकि एज वी ऑल नो ह्यूमन टेंडेंसी है कि अगर हम कोई भी चीज़ एक बार पढ़ते हैं तो हमें याद नहीं होती. हमें एक बेसिक आइडिया लग जाता है चीज़ का और उसको रिविजन की जरूरत है. सो मैंने एटलीस्ट ये करा था कि मैंने हर थ्योरी का मतलब जितने टॉपिक्स थे अपने हैंड रिटन नोट्स बनाए थे, और उस पूरे नोट्स को एटलीस्ट मेरे 2000-3000 पेज के नोट्स थे, और मैंने उन पूरे नोट्स को एटलीस्ट 5-6 टाइम्स रिवाइज करा था बिफोर माई एग्जाम्स. मतलब पूरे प्रिपरेशन के टाइम पीरियड में आई हैव रिवाइज दैट नोट्स अराउंड 5-6 टाइम्स, एंड स्टिल आई एम नॉट श्योर कि अभी तक मेरे को याद है. तो ऐसा नहीं है कि हम पढ़ेंगे बट मतलब कि हमें लगेगा कि हमें याद नहीं है. सबको एक बार फील आती है कि मेरे को याद नहीं हुई चीज़, बट ट्रस्ट मी कि अगर एग्जाम वाले दिन अगर आपने प्रैक्टिस करी हुई है तो आपकी प्रैक्टिस कभी गलत नहीं जाएगी. आप क्वेश्चन करेंगे तो आपके दिमाग में टॉपिक्स क्लियर होंगे जो आपने पढ़ा है. आपको पता लगेगा कि इस टॉपिक में से क्वेश्चन कैसे पूछे जाते हैं. सो प्रैक्टिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो प्रैक्टिस के लिए एक चीज़ मैंने और करी थी कि ड्यूरिंग द लास्ट 2 months मैंने हर वीकेंड पे सिर्फ और सिर्फ फुल लेंथ टेस्ट दिए थे. मैंने 3-4 टेस्ट सीरीज ज्वाइन करी थी, द बेस्ट वन बींग द ई लर्नम अनडाउटेडली, एंड वीरेन सर ने ऑब्वियसली ग्रुप्स पे डाउट क्लियर करे थे हमारे काफी जो प्रैक्टिस सीरीज में जो हमारे आए थे. और टेस्ट देना इज नॉट अ बिग थिंग, बट उसे एनालाइज करना इज इवन मोर इंपॉर्टेंट देन गिविंग द टेस्ट इटसेल्फ. सो मैंने हर वीकेंड पे एटलीस्ट 2 or 3 फुल लेंथ टेस्ट दिए थे और उनको एनालाइज करा था अच्छे से कि जो क्वेश्चन मेरे को नहीं आए उनकी स्टडी करी थी फ्रॉम गूगल, विकीपीडिया, अगर बुक्स में ना मिले तो सबसे पहले बुक्स, उसके बाद ग्रुप पे पूछे थे किसी से, उसके बाद नहीं तो गूगल या विकीपीडिया से. सो आई गेव अराउंड 40-45 टेस्ट इन ऑल, एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम इट आई सॉल्व द प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस ऑफ बोथ बायोटेक्नोलॉजी एंड एक्सेल अराउंड 3 टाइम्स. इसके अलावा पाथफाइंडर की एमसीक्यू वाली बुक आती है व्हाइट कवर पेज की, उस बुक को एटलीस्ट मैंने 2 or 3 बार उस बुक के भी सारे क्वेश्चंस करे थे ऑफ एवरी टॉपिक विच इज इन द गेट सिलेबस. सो प्रैक्टिस बहुत जरूरी है, लेकिन थ्योरी पे अपनी पकड़ बनाने के लिए रिवाइज करना भी उतना ही जरूरी है. सो आपको आवर्स देने पड़ेंगे स्टडी के, जिसमें कि एटलीस्ट मान लीजिए अगर आप 10 hours स्टडी कर रहे हैं तो 10 में से एटलीस्ट 7 hours आपको थ्योरी और 3 hours आपको प्रैक्टिस. और ड्यूरिंग वीकेंड्स आई यूज टू स्टडी मैथ्स, और इसके अलावा एप्टी भी आप पढ़ सकते हैं अगर आपको लगे कि एप्टी एस्पेक्ट आपका वीक है. तो प्रैक्टिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट और थ्योरी का रिवीजन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. टॉकिंग अबाउट माई ड्रीम एंड द फ्यूचर गोल्स, आई लव मॉलिक्युलर बायोलॉजी एंड जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग, जीन थेरेपी एस्पेक्ट्स एंड ऑल्सो द डायग्नोस्टिक एस्पेक्ट. सो आई वॉन्ट टू बी रिसर्चर इन दिस स्ट्रीम, एंड आई ऑल्सो वॉन्ट टू डू एंटरप्रेन्योरियल रिसर्च. सो रिसर्च विच कैन बी एडेड ऑन टू अ स्टार्टअप. सो वॉट आई एम लुकिंग फॉर इज टू डू अ स्टार्टअप इन दिस पर्टिकुलर फील्ड, एंड इफ इट इज नॉट सक्सेसफुल देन मूव अब्रॉड फॉर द रिसर्च. सो आई वुड लाइक टू डू एम टेक फर्स्ट, एंड आफ्टर दैट आई वुड लाइक टू मूव अब्रॉड फॉर माई PhD एंड फर्दर studies. And during that period, if I do a startup, then I would like to continue that in India because of the monetary aspect, definitely. So talking about the credits, and the major credit of this GATE AI Year 1, it goes to my parents at first. Undoubtedly, they always supported me in any situation. They knew that I am studying, so they never gave me any work to do. I did not do any single work during my preparation. And also to my friends whom I not talked to, they supported me during this entire preparation. My family also, and apart from this family and blood relations, I would like to thank Viren sir for this for unconditional support, and also the books definitely, who were the best friend of any aspirant. To all the new aspirants, I just have a single message that, buddy, your hard work will definitely pay off. So just keep your head down and do all the necessary hard work and it will definitely yield fruitful results. So what I did was that every day when I went to sleep, I thought that if I am better than yesterday or not. मतलब मैं every day जब भी सोने जाता था रात को, तो मैं एक चीज सोचता था कि क्या मैंने कल से आज कुछ better चीज, मतलब कुछ नया सीखा हूँ, कुछ क्या मैं better इंसान हूँ कल से. तो वो एक एक दिन जो है हर रात अगर आप ऐसा सोच के सोएंगे तो आप में एक मोटिवेशन रहेगा कि हाँ यार मेरे को आज के दिन कुछ अच्छा करना है. और एक एक दिन करके when you will see yourself ahead, when you are one year ahead of your time, जब अगले साल तुम खुद को देखोगे तो there would be a big big change. और हर चीज पे ऑफ करती है. आई एम नॉट अ गुड स्टूडेंट, आई वॉज नेवर अ गुड स्टूडेंट, आई वॉज नेवर अ टॉपर, बट स्टिल देर वॉज अ मोटिवेशन इन मी कि हाँ भाई रोज कुछ करना है. तो आप बेशक कितने ही मार्क्स हताश से पहले लाए हो, चाहे कितने ही फेलियर्स आपने लाइफ में देखे हो, चाहे आप पढ़ाई में मन ना लगता हो, चाहे आपको कुछ भी ना आता हो, बट स्टिल यू कैन बी AIR1. दिस इज द बिगेस्ट पॉइंट दैट आई हैव टेकन फ्रॉम माई जर्नी. सो सारे न्यू एस्पिरेंट्स को यही सब वो है कि भाई आप रेगुलरली प्रिपेयर करते रहिए, रेगुलरली पढ़ते रहिए, वीरेन सर की हेल्प लेते रहिए, उनके लेक्चर्स देखते रहिए, अपनी सेल्फ स्टडी करते रहिए, बुक्स पढ़ते रहिए, और इसके अलावा प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस करते रहिए. और सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट चीज, खुद पे ट्रस्ट रखें. योर हार्ड वर्क विल डेफिनेटली यील्ड गुड रिजल्ट्स. So towards the end of this, I would like to thank everyone who has helped me in any way. चाहे आपने मेरा एक भी doubt solve करा, तो I am still thankful to you कि आपने मेरी help करी कभी ना कभी. To all the group members जिन्होंने मेरी help करी वीरेन सर के group पे, वीरेन सर को special thanks, उन्होंने मेरे काफी doubt solve करे. बेशक कितनी मैंने उनसे डांट खाई, बट उस डांट के लिए भी I am thankful कि उससे मेरे को कुछ ना कुछ सीखने को ही मिला. बाकी वीरेन सर की शायरियाँ as you all know are very motivating. Keep watching them, keep being subscribed to this group, watching the videos of the channel, and always keep asking your doubts. No matter कितना ही छोटा doubt हो, उसको पूछ के please clear करिए, ठीक है? तो जितने ज्यादा doubts clear होंगे, उतना better आपका score रहेगा. So I would like to thank everyone who has ever helped me in my life, and let's stay connected and see you in IIT someday. So keep preparing, keep working hard, and again thanks to Viren sir and every person of this group and the e-learning platform. Thanks a lot.